not just on the late great grand chief, but more or less on the future and history of our country going forward as we look back in the past. So thank you, Governor. I'm privileged to have a governor who's very proactive and responsive. Instead of waiting on Prime Minister to initiate, sometimes when governors take a lead like this, it just makes our job much, much easier. And especially for a Pangolet government who believes in devolving powers and functions to the sub-national government levels for leadership and activities, Governor, let me place on record sincerely your great leadership in ensuring that such key activities that can be handled at the provincial level is being handled without much encouragement or without much instruction from the national government. Thank you, Governor Pakop. And the city municipal, I acknowledge an important member of the city, which is the member for Mosby Northeast. Thank you again for your presence and partnership in this space. We are creating a legacy that will forever stand out in reminding our children and their children on what life was in the 60s and 70s, especially our country's life that is attached with the great grand chief's life. So thank you very much, city administrator, and everyone at the city hall who ensured this moment has arrived for us to launch out and step into creating a unity, a peace and unity park that is reflective of the life of the founding father of our nation, the great grand chief, Sir Michael Thomas O'Malley. I'm here with Minister for Lands to give signal that at the national government level, we are all in total support to what will be continual life and continuity of the Somara influence in our country going forward into the future. So I acknowledge all who are here. I do thank my brother and sister Hatem and Dalsi for coming in. Sadadi Toka, a senior who has been a very close friend of the late great grand chief. As we unveil this park, this will be part of a body of activities that will ensure Somara lives on in the psychic and the mindset and in the public policy space and our national character. Even in his passing, he lives on going on into the future. Somara is PNG and PNG is Somara. They are synonymous. At 1968, as I was saying over his funeral processions during his funeral programs, he bulldozed everything in front of him, and in just 7 years, and his entry in parliament in 1968, and by 1975 we were politically independent, and from then on he marched on. He marched on into ensuring that our country remained united. And there can be no greater evidence than in his passing, the country came in total unity. That is personified. Unity in our country is personified in the late great chief and his influence on our country. And as I said, we want to construct a future in which the father of our nation is still speaking to the nation, even when he's Western or in West. And so such a park here, and I envisage a park where it has library in it, a park where there's monument in it, a park where there's a place where Papua New Guineans can come and see the history of Somara and see the history of our country, so that we could look into our parliament. It speaks into the national parliament. It speaks into our judiciary that is just next door. It speaks into the business society that is here in Waikani and in our country. It speaks into the seat of government, the executive in our country, the ideals that our country is based on, free, democratic nation, a Christian nation, though a thousand tribe we may be, but we still remain united under one flag, one constitution, one people, the ideals that Somara stood for, and upon his death, it was clearly evident that the country came in total unity. And so, what a governor, what a fitting place to allocate to the Somara Foundation. Let me announce that working in the, with the family, the Somara Foundation was there, and Somara Foundation will be, for want of better word, I'll say resuscitated or rebranded, and for us to give meaning so that Somara, even in passing can be still actively speaking to the way governments of today and governments of past, public service of today and public service, sort of governments of today and governments of the future, public service of today and public service of the future, business of today and business of the future, citizens of today and citizens of the future, what Papua New Guinea must be, lest we forget how we've came. We must be guided by the past to ensure the future we construct maintains the humble, noble, but pure intentions of our fathers of our nation in 1975 and beyond, before them, and how they constructed Somare and Somare's foundation here at the Peace Park, and other links that they will, the Somare Foundation will establish link with, can continue to speak to the national conscience on what our country must be going forward. And I look forward to associating myself with the Somare Foundation, with the NCD and the City Hall for this place, not just this Peace Park, but also the other important monuments and sites throughout our country that we will create in honor of our great-grandchief. I look forward, not just myself, but the entire arm of the executive government. We look forward to ensuring that this unveiling gives rise to creation of many monuments, many institutions, especially that rotates around the Somare Foundation for Great Grandchief Somare, to speak on into us, even in his passing. Thank you very much, Governor, once again, for making this moment possible. God bless NCD, God bless Papua New Guinea, God bless the Somare family, and may long live the Somare influence into our country going on into the future. God bless. We're going to build, working with the Somare Foundation, we hope to build a library, hope to build a conference facility, the institution we live on. And we are envisaging, speaking with the family and all of us in government, we are envisaging a life institution that will born out of this place, so Papua New Guineans can come in and learn from this and what our country was. And it's just not going to be grass and greenery. Grass and greenery will be here. We will redesign this place properly. And the National Executive Council has attached some other foundation to work with the museum to enter here and we went. Two important, significant sites. And along this boulevard, we'll be all reconstructed with a plan with the city on how this boulevard will be constructed. On the other side, the other prime ministers will have their own space. So their space for them to have their own little space for their, similar to Somare, but Somare, of course, is Somare, and he deserves a far greater space, bigger space. We'll give it to him on this side. We'll allocate the other space to the other prime ministers, including the two that have passed through, and others for their own space, so they could have their own library. Something similar, if you go to Washington, you would see there's a space for all former presidents along the way, linking to the parliament. And right up to the hill on the other side, we'll have a national unity pillar, the PNG Council of Churches, that will mount. So this will become a public precinct, and in public events, people can come here and people are speaking in the face of the people's house. So it is in this context that we are unveiling the Somare Peace and Unity Park, and national government will give full support. We've already allocated in an allocation for Somare Museum 3 million kina in a cabinet edition last year, and 2 million for what would have been his national tour. Unfortunately, COVID and other situations compounded where he could not have moved around. We just started the Imbongu movement, and he was kept in houses in as far as last year was concerned. But anyway, there's space for that. This is an area we will do and modernize. It becomes a very nice park, working with the Parks and Gardens of the NCD, working with museum, and hopefully something that we could truly be proud of. I am totally privileged, Governor, standing with Nelson and Arthur on the side, representing the Somare Foundation, a family friend, that are the good member, minister, city hall, national governing board, you are here. Without preempting you, thank you, Chairman Clement Malo, Clement Kanal. You are here already, so you now you attest to this development. You are commissioner in the city, okay? I didn't know that, but I've made a statement here, so you know what to do now. All right.
Okay, you can announce.
That's it. You are in Manhattan. Governor, you are in Manhattan.
Okay. Formally announced.
I'll see you, Governor, to ensure this becomes a truly peace and unity path.
Can you
all turn around? The late Grand Chief Sir Michael Thomas Tomare will live and continue to speak to us as children of this country.
Okay, we come now. Fully come.
Okay.
Come now.
We love you and God bless you. Yeah. The children say, Michael, Samara.